Thank you, Ben, Jay, John. What a thriller in Fort Collins. Minnesota escapes here. Number 22, Arizona, two quick scores. Nevada on their third possession, moving the football, faced with third down and three. Tyler Stewart, the junior quarterback, out of that pistol. He'll throw it, and he's got a man and a catch. Evan Fonts, the tight end. And a first down for the Nevada Wolfpack inside the Arizona 10. They mark it at the 8.
Really well done. This is faking the read option. And it looks like Stewart's going to run it, but then the Arizona defensive backs losing the tight end in coverage. And that was a key third down, something that they've really struggled with so far here in this first quarter.
Arizona put two touchdowns on the board in the first 6 minutes of play. Stewart with Don Jackson behind him. First and goal from the 8. And it's Jackson straight ahead to the 5. And that's when Arizona's defense gets a hold of him. They'll actually mark it outside the 5. Second down and goal.
Well, what you notice the difference here in this drive as opposed to the first drive has been third down, something where Arizona struggled with last week. Came out and did a very good job in the first two drives of the game, but here on this one, two key third downs. The first one, a screen pass versus pressure, and the second one, Stewart hitting his tight end is setting this offense up in a really good position.
Jackson behind him, Stewart from the 6, second and goal. Flag down, flip it, Jackson, touchdown. A flag back at the 7. Nevada is in the end zone, but does it count?
Illegal formation. More than 4 in the backfield on offense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Illegal formation. Marvell July, the referee. This is a Mountain West Conference crew.
Well, this is an unbalanced formation, and you have to have 6 on the line of scrimmage. This is something that Nick Rolovich said they wanted to do, playing with the formation. They got exactly what they wanted. They attacked the safety, Tellus Jones, in no man's land, but a little lapse in judgment on the details wipes off 6 points off the board.
Brian Polian obviously steamed on the Nevada sideline. Still second and goal now from the 11. Direct snap. The throw from Richardson. And it's caught by Stewart, the quarterback. And he's not even in bounds. So a lot of Nevada players touch the ball. And it's all for nothing.
Well, that's a lot of work for not much. You're going to see Hassan Henderson down here. He's going to come open just at the last second on the end zone. Boy, that is a lot of work for an incomplete pass. 2 negative plays right now put you at 3rd and goal from the 11-yard line. This is not what you want to have happen on your best drive of the game, down by 14.
Nevada has a big receiver and a good one. Hassan Henderson at 6'5". He's split to the near side. Stewart lays it up. It's Henderson, and it's incomplete in the corner of the end zone. Devontae Neal with good coverage for Arizona.
Well, excellent coverage by Devontae Neal. 5'10", 173 pounds against a 6'5" wide receiver. And he was in great position. There was nowhere for Tyler Stewart to throw the ball. Excellent job being aggressive by Devontae Neal, playing his second game of his career at cornerback.
So Nevada driving down the field has to settle for a shot at a field goal. It's a 28-yard attempt. Brent Zuzo, a junior kicker. And Zuzo knocks it through. Nevada on their heels after 2 Arizona scores, has 3. Number 22 up on the road in Reno. 14-3, number 22 Arizona on the road. The Wolfpack of Nevada 3. Rich Waltz along with Adam Archuleta. Cassie Gallo on the sidelines. A disastrous start for Nevada. Adam, their first possession, 3 and out, and that's when the madness began.
Yeah, it was huge. It was Arizona's defense doing a good job forcing the 3 and out and getting off of the field. And the first punt of the game, a bad snap over the head, which results in a terrible punt. And after getting set up in great field position, Solomon quickly takes advantage of that and finds Jackson in the end zone for their very first touchdown. And again, their second possession of the game, they're able to methodically drive down the field for a very quick 14-point lead.
You can see in the game summary right off the start, a pair of three and outs for Nevada on their first drive. And Nevada will kick off. Arizona's offense has been sharp from the get-go. Samaje Grant, Jared Baker deep for the Wildcats. And this one sends Grant back. He'll take a knee. And Arizona will get the football at their own 25-yard line. The Wildcats at 1-0, champions of the Pac-12 South. Chick-fil-A starting lineups. So many weapons in the spread. A lot of those are on the outside. One big one is in the backfield, and that's Nick Wilson. Anu Solomon, 6 of 6, 63 yards and a touchdown. And that's already a nice first half. And there's 5 minutes left here in the first quarter. Wilson, boy, he's been active and good. That's 11 yards on the pickup and another first down for Arizona. Matthew Lyons made the stop for Nevada.
A big part of their offense is getting Nick Wilson involved early. He had 103 yards last week, but 83 of those in that second half. This has to be a run-first offense.
And it's been Nick Wilson first. Out to the 44-yard line. Wilson behind an offensive line with all the weapons on the outside.
They have a terrific wide receiver core. Their quarterback is in his second year of the system, but I still think that this offense will run through Nick Wilson this season. He is terrific in the open field, and you can see today running with a purpose.
Wilson again, midfield, inside the 45, busting tackles, another first down. Kendall Johnson with the stop. He's down to the 42-yard line, first and 10, Arizona.
On the backside right now for the Nevada defense, having a very difficult time closing up that space. And you're not going to get an arm tackle on Wilson with that much space.
Solomon looks to throw. Hit as he throws, and it's incomplete. Nevada defensively, a rough start. Their strength, though, is in their front seven.
This is an active front seven, an active defensive line that's loaded with juniors and seniors. Ian Seau is the guy that's getting a ton of hype around the Mountain West, the guy that can rush the passer. But in order to rush that passer, you have to get in third and long, something that they haven't been able to do so far today.
Second and 10, Solomon. Pump fake, hit, unloads, and the caught made by Nate Phillips at the 42-yard line, and he's taken down by Elijah Mitchell, the junior corner.
What awareness. And one thing that when you study this offense is that the quarterback doesn't always play a traditional drop-back game. One of his strengths is to be able to improvise and dump off the ball to his receivers.
Third down, 8. And a timeout by Nevada. Brian Polian calls the timeout, 3rd and 8 for Arizona, when we return to Reno. Number 22, Arizona, an early lead over Nevada. 3:35 left, first quarter. TrueCar keys to success.
Well, they've done this so far in this game. 6 carries, 42 yards. Defensively, we need the disruptors to show up. Tackles for a loss, sacks, pressure on the quarterback. For Nevada, they have to attack Arizona's perimeter. I think they have speed at running back in Don Jackson to take advantage over inexperienced linebackers. And defensively, no yak. No yards after contact, no yards after the catch. They have to have a perfect tackling game on defense to slow down an explosive offense like this.
It's been an explosive first quarter for Brian Polian. His team fell down 14-0, angered by a call as Nevada was going in to score. Now his defense facing their first third down of the ball game. From the 40, Solomon, sideline, has a man. It's Grant, and he's hit short of the first down. but it might just be four down territory here for Arizona.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised with the way they're running the ball and the success they've had right here offensively that Rich Rodriguez doesn't go for this place. I think it's a great call right now. Nick Wilson is running tough. Look for the cutback. There's a screen formation right here with three receivers at the top.
Arizona with a timeout. Rich Rodriguez and the Wildcats. Two
timeout
quick scores.
Arizona.
A 14-3 lead in Reno.
Media timeout.
Arizona football, fourth and one at the Nevada 33-yard line. Rich Waltz, Adam Archuleta, Cassie Gallo. What's going on with Rich Rodriguez, Adam?
Before that timeout, they lined up in a formation to get Samaje Grant on a wide receiver screen. Three receivers to the right. But I think they're going to rethink this. And if I were them, I would ride Nick Wilson because that backside on his cutback has yet to be closed down by the defensive end. And that's a place where I would try and attack.
Six carries, 42 yards for Wilson already. And he's in the backfield with Solomon on this fourth down and one. It's fumbled. Solomon has it. He's shot of the first down. Jordan Dobrich made the stop. Solomon just shy of the first down. And Nevada with an enormous hold in their own territory.
Well, you got to take advantage of the miscue, and it looked like Solomon just took his hand off of his eyes off of the ball. It looked like he didn't look the ball in. He looked up to try and get his read before he secured the ball. Nick Wilson was very quick to the hole right there. So a miscue by the Arizona offense, giving the Wolfpack a little bit of life.
Now Nevada gets the football. Chick-fil-A bringing you the starting lineups. Tyler Stewart, their quarterback. And a spinning run by James Butler. No gain on the play. There's the junior quarterback, big shoes to fill. Cody Fajardo and then Colin Kaepernick. Together, they combined for almost 25,000 yards of total offense.
Both of those guys were four-year starters that were tremendous run and passing threats. And Tyler Stewart had a quarterback competition this offseason, and the main reason why he won was because of his preparation. And Coach Polian and the offensive staff saw him getting better and better, doing the little things week in and week out, and that's why he was able to win the job.
Second and 10. Little flip, Jericho Richardson outside to the 35, a flag down, and Richardson is down at the 40. Devontae Neal made the stop. A key penalty squashed a Nevada touchdown on their last possession. And Marvell July, the referee, and Brian Polian had a heated exchange for almost a minute after that play.
Now, I think there was a question. They called too many men in the backfield on that one formation.
Personal foul. Illegal block below one of the plays. Offense number 20. 15 yards from the clock. Spot foul. Replay second down.
Well, you're going to see James Butler, number 20, right there. And he went for a cut block. I'm not quite sure, honestly, why that was called an illegal block below the waist.
Hassan Henderson, a tall target on the outside for Tyler Stewart. And that was Henderson, who was the target on third and goal on that last possession. This is second down and 25. Stewart, flushed and cut from behind. Derek Turi-Turi, the junior linebacker out of Central Point, Oregon, made the stop. Now, this defense is without one of the best players in the country. Scooby Wright, their linebacker, is out. But William Parks was all over the field last week.
As defense needs disruptors, Scooby Wright, who had 14 sacks last year, 29 tackles for the loss, was the guy that wreaked havoc on opposing offenses. And right now, it's yet to be seen
who that player to step up is going to be. Will Parks had a tremendous game last week, had a breakout year last year. I expect him, as this season goes on, to be a big playmaker.
Third down and a bunch, 21. Screen pass. Butler escapes. Butler is out to the 40, but he's still 4 yards shy of a first down. And Nevada will be forced to punt. A lot of football has been played, and there's a minute left in this first quarter here in Reno.
Well, Arizona took advantage of that very first miscue. Great field position. I think Anu Solomon has been sharp so far in this game. Nick Wilson has got off to a terrific start. Offensively for the Wolfpack, they really struggled in those very first two drives. But the story here in the last two drives have been penalties and self-inflicted wounds that have really hurt them.
Alex Boy, end-over-end kick. Devontae Neal at the 15. Let's go down below to Cassie Gallo. Cassie?
Well, Rich, Arizona head coach Rich Rodriguez and Wolfpack defensive coordinator Scott Boone have gone back 20 years. They coached against each other in Division III when Coach Rodriguez developed the spread. The two became quick friends, still stay in touch. Talked to both coaches this week about early days. They agree they both come a long way, as well as that spread offense, Rich.
Yeah, the spread offense, Rich Rodriguez, the second time he got a head coaching job in Glenville State. Just figured, you know what, let's take a flyer on something. And that's an offense that has permeated not only college football, but high school football across this country. And Anu Solomon, Arizona's quarterback, runs it so well. Solomon, middle, and it's incomplete through the hands of Samaje Grant, the junior wide receiver. Kendall Johnson on the coverage for Nevada. There's a flag down in the backfield.
Personal foul. Defense, number 92, illegal use of the hands to the face. 15-yard, automatic first down.
That is the fifth penalty on Nevada, and three of them have been absolute killers.
Yeah, when you're playing against a team that has better athletes and more depth, and you're an underdog, you can't have the miscues. And so far, offensively now, penalties have hurt, and you just can't give an offense like this with so much potential more cracks to get a first down.
Solomon's throw, good play by Kendall Johnson to wrap up Nate Phillips. That catch at the 36-yard line.
I was talking to Rich Rodriguez before the game, and I said, hey, what's going to be the next step for Solomon? What's going to make him take control of this offense and get to the next level? And he likened it to a point guard in basketball, and he said, look, it's about identifying the fast break, not necessarily getting it to the right guy, but getting it to him with the right timing. And once he does that, then this offense is going to be able to take that next step.
Well, the first two steps by Arizona here, pretty darn impressive. Two touchdowns right out of the gates, and number 22 on the road on top, 14-3.
Only pure also. College football on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. By TrueCar. When buying a car, save time, save money, and never overpay. Visit TrueCar.com. And by Advocare. We build champions.
Biggest little city in the world, host of number 22, Arizona. And Arizona up 14-3. Allegra brings you the weather. Actually, a break in the weather. Temperatures were supposed to be 98, 99. Right now, comfortable at 94, low humidity. And on second down and five, a new Solomon's throw sails out of bounds. Arizona's faced with third down and five. Solomon's been really good so far. 9 of 11, 77 yards, and a touchdown.
A lot of it's been featuring short passing game. And when we talked to the staff this week, they said the main thing they want to see is execution, but they want to take advantage and they want to hit some shots downfield, something they didn't do a lot of last week.
Their second third down, Solomon lots of time. Crossing route, Jones drops it, and Nevada holds again and will get the football back.
Well, twice now, their only two third downs of the game, they did not convert. 0 for 2.
And that's an easy one that Caleb Jones should be able to bring in. That was right in his hands, just a lapse of concentration. And now you're putting the ball away.
Both these teams have two really good kickers. Drew Riggleman is the punter for Arizona. Andrew Sellis, a redshirt freshman, is deep. And a high wobbly kick lands at the 32, takes an Arizona bounce inside the 20 to the 19-yard line. Last year, these two teams played in Tucson, and it was a shootout. Nick Wilson early, 171 yards on the day. Anu Solomon was just a freshman. He didn't play like it. 278 yards through the air. Cody Fajardo kept Nevada in striking distance. But the Wolfpack's last second throw was incomplete, 35-28. And of course, Rich Rodriguez and Arizona would go on to stun everybody, win the Pac-12 South, and get themselves into that Pac-12 championship game and into the Fiesta Bowl. Nevada, their own 19-yard line. Tyler Stewart, Don Jackson left side, and Jackson crosses one across the 30, out to the 33-yard line. A gain of 13. Jamar Ala made the stop for Arizona.
But all centers on this running game. Don Jackson in this running attack, only 16 yards in that first quarter. And he does just a tremendous job of finding that seam in behind his left guard and his center, Adam Corey and Nathan Goltry.
And on first and 10, again, Jackson. Out of bounds, 38-yard line. That's a gain of 6. Sir Thomas Jackson made the stop for the Wildcats.
Well, the key to this running game up front with an offensive line that doesn't have a lot of experience is their ability to get up and climb onto those linebackers. And look, there's a group, a linebacking group for Arizona that does not have a lot of experience. Scooby Wright is out. His backup, Hayden Gregory, was hurt in the first quarter. So you're dealing with a lot of inexperience. Now, this should set up that play-action pass, something this defense had a hard time with last week.
Second down 5, there's the play action and the throw on the money to Richardson. Flags come down in the backfield away from the catch in the defensive backfield. Already a lot of laundry in this one. There's a catch, a push there. Curious that the flag came from about 30 yards away and not from the side judge there.
Yeah, it wasn't a hard push,
no
but it
foul.
Was still a push.
Office pass interference. The pass was caught at the line of scrimmage. First down.
It's not a devastating push, but he was pretty far into the white right there, and that's just a major lapse given this offense.
Correction. Third.
Did they pick the flag up? I believe they picked the flag up. Brian Polian is angry again, and he has spent the entire game with a red face. So it's third down and short. Jackson hit right at the stick, and he falls forward. Looks like he has the first down. Luca Bruno hit him first. Good second effort by the senior out of Sacramento, California.
Well, so far tonight, boy, Brian Polian not on the right end of the penalty flag situation. And we didn't get a very good explanation for what happened right there. It looked as if that was going to be a personal foul, but
it is good for the first down.
And nonetheless, Nevada gets a chance to pick up a first down on third and short. It was good penetration up front from the defensive tackle, Luca Bruno, but boy, Don Jackson finishing that run.
From the 43, Jackson again. They like this left side, and why not? Jackson, another nice game. That's a 7-yard pickup. Second down and 3. Again, this is a Mountain West officiating crew.
Well, coming into this game, they really felt like two tight end sets, especially when they line up in a wing formation, was going to give this defense some trouble. And right now, they're running behind their best offensive lineman, Austin Corbett, to the left with two tight ends and having great success.
Again, to the left side, but this time it's Butler, and James Butler spins forward, a gain of 5, and he's got the first down. And all of a sudden, Nevada has their rhythm, and they're moving the football.
It kind of reminds you what happened last week a little bit to this defense. It's their ability to not get off the field and allowing UTSA to run for 193 yards. So somebody up front in this front 7 has to step up and make a play. Tellus Jones was brilliant from his safety spot in the first 2 drives of the game, but we haven't called his number since.
From the Arizona 46. Butler. And he's got 4. University of Texas, San Antonio. That was last week for Arizona, the game tighter than many thought it would be. Nevada had UC Davis. Really tough to judge, and even both coaches told us that they weren't sure what they had after last week.
Yeah, really hard to judge. You know, I think Nevada severely was outmatched UC Davis, and they knew that this was going to be a monumental challenge going up against a team like Arizona. But Arizona, you could argue, didn't really play like maybe people would have expected to against a team they should have dominated.
Butler bounces outside, inside the 40, inside the 35, and right now Nevada is just churning and picking up 6, 7, 8 yards of crack.
Jared Houston, the tight end for Nevada. You're going to watch the cornerback blitz by Sammy Morrison, and Jared Gibson, the tight end, blocked him, and that allowed James Butler to get to the corner.
One of Brian Polian's favorite sayings for his team is keep chopping. They were a great comeback team last year. They were down 14-0, 5 minutes into this ballgame. And methodically, they are running themselves back into the game. Stewart sets, now flushed. And he fires it out of bounds and incomplete.
Boy, Stewart had Richardson wide open. And for whatever reason, watch down here, Richardson, one-on-one matchup, he has him beat. And for whatever reason, I don't know if it was because of the pressure, but Tyler Stewart didn't throw that ball. That is a touchdown right there if you pull the trigger.
Missed opportunities for Nevada. They had a touchdown negated by a penalty. And now they're faced with second down and 10.
That's one of those in a one-on-one matchup. When you win the route, and you have the opportunity, you have to maximize.
Jackson again. Jackson still on his feet, down to the 15-yard line. Don Jackson, the feature back on this drive. And Nevada's got a first down, 18 yards on the carry.
Boy, Jeremy McCauley, the right guard, watched the wash down the line of scrimmage right there. I mean, they pushed that defensive line all the way back. And what about that one-on-one move right there to break the tackle of the DB?
Jackson again bounces outside, inside the 10. Jamar Allah, and again a left side run for the Wolfpack.
Yeah, here it is, the two tight end sets with Gibson and Matt Moen, along with Austin Corbett, the left tackle, is really getting after that defensive front. Somebody has to get over there and set that edge.
Verizon Red Zone. Last year, Nevada was one of the best in the country in the red zone. They were 6th in the nation. 49 of 53 scores in the red zone last year.
And last week, 5 for 5, 4 touchdowns. But again, that was UC Davis, a team that they should have been better than. Now you're going up against the reigning Pac-12 South champion. And outside of those first 2 drives, where they were kind of controlling this offense, the Wolfpack had been able to move the ball. It's a lot of the things that showed up last week against UTSA is showing up here in this game. The inability to stop those outside runs by this defensive front 7.
University of Texas, San Antonio ran 95 plays last week. That is a large, large number for a defense.
And what did Rich Rodriguez say? He said, look, we can't allow a team to dictate a tempo like that. We've got to be able to get them into a third and long situations, so then maybe we can pressure and get off the field and force some three and outs and get the ball back to our offense.
11 plays already on this drive. This is number 12. 73 yards. All but two have been runs. Jackson in the backfield.
Here it is. Same formation. Two tight end wing set.
And it's Jackson behind that set. He's down to the five. And it looks like he's got the first down. William Parks made the stop for Arizona.
Adam Corey up front, the guard, Nathan Goldtree, Jeremy McCauley. They're running a zone blocking scheme right now and completely washing away that defensive front four, and the running backs doing a good job of making the right cuts and getting positive yardage.
Adam Corey, the sophomore. 10 minutes left, first half. Nevada on the doorstep here. First and goal. Jackson, and this time, maybe a yard. Derek Turi-Turi, the junior linebacker, made the stop.
They like Derek Turi-Turi, and they really do feel a guy that is just built at 6'1", 265 pounds. They feel like he's a guy that can win one-on-one. And without Scooby Wright in the lineup, somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's Turi-Turi on one end or it's Reggie Gilbert on the other end. But somebody in this front seven, if they want to win deep in the Pac-12 play, has to be able to step up and win those one-on-one battles. They're a really good job in the run game, stuffing it at the line of scrimmage.
Second and goal. Stewart, end zone, touchdown, it's Richardson. Jericho Richardson from Tyler Stewart. And Nevada has gotten up off the canvas and controlled it in four with this extra point.
Well, credit Brian Polian and Nick Rolovich, the offensive coordinator, was sticking with the run. And they felt like coming into this game, they would have to run the ball well. Arizona knew they had to stop the run. And it'd be very tempting after being down 14 points to abandon it, but they stuck with it. And you can see it's really working, especially on that left side.
Extra point good. 14 plays, 81 yards, 5.5 minutes. Now that is an answer. Nevada draws within four of number 22, Arizona. No panic here in Reno. The Wolfpack fell down 14-0 to number 22, Arizona. Nick Rolovich, the offensive coordinator, talking to his offense. Adam Archuleta, there's the feature back. Don Jackson on that drive, 72 yards rushing.
He's the most exciting player on this offense and really kind of the light bulb. He was good last year, but now in his senior year, he has really started to take off. And the fact that they were patient, they stuck with the run. They've identified a formation that the Wildcats are having a very hard time defending. And right now, until they prove they can stop it, I would anticipate running behind your left tackle, Austin Corbett, and the two tight ends the next time they're on offense.
Jared Baker can't chase this one down. And it's through the end zone. Arizona got their first touchdown through the air. Anu Solomon hit Johnny Jackson, the senior wide receiver, with a touchdown. Jackson, part of our Driven to Succeed, brought to you by Cooper Tires. Switched to wide receiver in August. 8 catches last week, over 100 yards. And so the Wildcats with the football, with the lead. But right now, Nevada has all the momentum. Solomon gives it, Nick Wilson breaks loose. Wilson midfield. Nick Wilson down to the 40-yard line of Nevada. That's a 34-yard pickup. That will get you momentum right back.
Now, what we say is one of the keys here for Nevada's defense is tackling. Nick Wilson is so hard to tackle in space. And if you don't make those one-on-one plays, he's going to have a heck of a night.
Marked right at the 40. Sullivan looking. And his throw is caught. It's Richards. David Richards fights inside the 15. Down to the 14-yard line. And just like that, Arizona is moving 26 yards on that pickup.
This is what makes the offense so hard to defend. Nick Wilson just rips it for a big run. This time, Anu Solomon pulls it, and he's got the run and the pass option, and just when his receiver opens up, he hits him, and now the Wildcat offense is rolling.
Arizona up four, and their offense is back in business.
Well, here's that long run by Nick Wilson. These are the two linebackers right here, Jordan Dobrich and Matthew Lyons, and they get stuck on blocks. When you play a spread team, you have to get off the blocks. Look at 49 right there, can't get off in time, and then Nick Wilson is able to read those cuts. He makes the free safety, Asani Rufus miss, and that's how this offense starts to get on track. But the key is front seven, you must get off blocks, and you can't allow a guy like Nick Wilson to have easy access to your secondary.
Two plays have eaten up 55 yards, and Solomon on play action, swing pass, it's caught, Josh Kern, the tight end, to the 12-yard line, and it's a gain of four. Asani Rufus, the redshirt freshman safety, made the stop.
As so many quarterbacks, traditional quarterbacks, kind of like Tyler Stewart, make a lot of their decisions before the snap, identifying the defense. But for Solomon, the decision-making process starts after the snap, and he has to do so much after the snap and make the right decision he's been doing today.
Wilson. And Solomon the keeper, and Solomon to the eight, short of the first down, and it's another third down for Arizona.
Well, this is the guy, number eight, Ian Seau, is the guy you have to talk about with the Wolfpack defense. He's been quiet so far here tonight, but does a good job of recognizing and getting to Solomon.
0-2 on third down. Solomon tips. Caught right on the stick. Caleb Jones reaches, and he is short of the first down.
Boy, good job by Randy Uzoma, the junior cornerback out there, trying to sprint out to the right and draw the defense that way and hit the throwback. But Uzoma all over it again. Right now, you better believe I would call number 28's number. He's the guy to pick up this first down.
Fourth and one. Will they run a play, or are they just trying to draw Nevada offsides?
I think the way you've been running the ball on this drive, no question, Nick Wilson's your guy.
Wilson stuffed. Stuffed.
Boy, Kevin McReynolds, the transfer from UCLA, dominates up front. Watch him stone the left guard, Zach Hamela, get off of the block and make the play on Wilson in the backfield. I mean, that's why they brought him here from UCLA. And boy, when you have to make a play on critical downs, you've got to be able to win those one-on-one matchups. Excellent job by Kevin McReynolds.
6'2", 300 pounds, and McReynolds, for the second time, Nevada stopping Arizona on fourth and a yard. First and 10 now, and flags.
Ball start, offense number 72, half the distance to the goal, first down.
Adam Schein brings his unmatched enthusiasm to a whole new level. And you never know what he'll say next. Time to Schein, Tuesday through Friday, 6 Eastern, CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. In Reno, Mackey Stadium, a loud and boisterous crowd for number 22, Arizona. Pac-12 on the road, Mountain West at home. Tyler Stewart on his goal line. A quick hop to Richardson, who had the touchdown catch, and he makes this one at the 7-yard line. It'll bring up second down and about 12.
Well, this is a tough place to be. It was a great job by your defense to give the ball back to the offense right here, but that first false start really puts you in a bad situation trying to operate right now inside of your own 10-yard line. Not a lot of offense that you can call, because the worst thing that can happen right now is get Arizona with a big defensive play.
On second down, Stewart hit, captured, and in the end zone. Let's see where they mark it. Arizona wants a safety. They're going to mark it outside the end zone and just inside the one. Jeff Worthy made the stop. And that was nearly 2 points for the Wildcats.
Boy, Jeff Worthy just right off the edge, unblocked. And that's, boy, that's so dangerous. The question is, did that ball get behind the line completely? And it's really hard with the camera angles that we see, but it looked like that ball stayed outside of the goal line, and that's why it wasn't called a safety. But boy, that's a dangerous play right now, right there.
Time out.
Trying to
Arizona.
Have a ball handling
the second
situation
half.
With Tyler Stewart.
30 seconds.
This is a play that can be reviewed. Arizona takes a timeout, and here's another look.
So the question is, does the ball go into the end zone? Contact is made outside the end zone.
And it looks like the ball is still out.
And it looks like the ball is still out. Contact was made with the ball outside of the goal line. But those are some of the impact plays, I think, Rich, that you've got to have for this Arizona defense. Guys that are disrupting and getting into the backfield. And there, I think, contact was initiated before the ball got completely behind the goal line.
Worthy, the senior, transfer from Boise State. Last look. So Tyler Stewart now in his end zone on third and 18. Another whistle.
Timeout, Nevada. The third and final of the half.
Calls a timeout. It's their last one.
Media timeout
of
also.
This first half. 5.5 minutes left. First half in Reno. Arizona up 14-10. Brian Polian in his third year here at Nevada. And right now, after a 14-0 start by Arizona, the Wolfpack within four, but third down and forever with the ball right up against the goal line.
Well, that's a sloppy series here, and just a terrible way to follow up was what was a very impressive drive, the drive before. But also credit the Arizona defense for making a couple plays as well.
What do you do here? Do you settle for just a little bit of breathing room?
That's all you got.
Bouncing outside is Butler, and he's thrown out of bounds at the 4-yard line. So there's your breathing room.
Not much breathing room.
Now remember, after the opening three and out by Nevada, the Wolfpack messed up a punt. Alex Boy, a bad snap, he couldn't hold it, scrambled, kicked it out of bounds, and that set up Arizona's first score.
And what did Brian Polian say he was really concerned about is Arizona's return game. He thought that they were just terrific and was very nervous about when Arizona was returning a kick or a punt.
Alex Boy with a booming kick, and a nice catch there. Devontae Neal starts to his left. To the sideline, Neal with a healthy return to the Nevada 40-yard line. It's a 19-yard return. Thursday Night Football is back, and it kicks off this Thursday on CBS and the NFL Network. Denver and Kansas City. Primetime football starts here Thursday nights on CBS and the NFL Network. And the father of Brian Polian certainly bears some responsibility for Peyton Manning's tenure in Indianapolis and a Super Bowl trophy. So much so that Manning made sure he was there on that great day when Bill Polian went into the Hall of Fame this fall. Now Arizona. Solomon takes a shot down the middle. He had two receivers in the pattern. And it's incomplete, second down and 10.
Well, they had it right there. Another missed opportunity. Nate Phillips just put a nasty double move. I couldn't quite see where the DB was, but that was wide open right there. And a missed throw by Solomon.
Nevada did not get back to line up on the snap. And Arizona exploits it with a throw to the sideline to Nick Wilson. Sloppy play by the Nevada defense. There were four men running to get into position when the ball was snapped. From the 28 of Nevada. Wilson busts to the five. And Nick Wilson, the sophomore out of Fresno, 23 yards. First and goal.
Well, Jacob Alsadek, the right guard, gets up on the linebacker again. And just like Arizona not having an answer for Nevada's off-tackle run, right now Nick Wilson enjoying a lot of success off of his left side.
Solomon keeps and is grabbed at the two. Second and goal.
That's the second time you saw the big first big run by Wilson on the drive previous that was virtually untouched, getting in the secondary, and there again. A gaping hole with the linebackers unable to fill up inside.
Some help in the backfield for Wilson. Second and goal. Wilson outside in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Jamardre Cobb with a key block on the play.
It's just speed right there. Kendall Johnson, the free safety, was responsible for containing. He was outside, could not get off the block quick enough, and Wilson just too fast.
Extra point is good. Arizona has put it in the end zone three times here in the first half. Number 22 on the road. Number 28 in the end zone. Nick Wilson and Arizona up in Reno. Good first half of football for number 22, Arizona. A 21-10 lead here in Reno over the Wolfpack of Nevada. Rich Waltz, Adam Archuleta, Cassie Gallo. And there's your scoring drive. Nick Wilson's having quite a night already.
It was key to get him involved early in this game.
Mitchell will keep it in the end zone. Verizon Halftime Report, busy day, obviously, in college football. Brent Stover, Houston Nutt, Christian Poirier in our New York studio. Updates, highlights from across the nation. First half highlights and stats from this one. Some of the stories, some of the games. You will see Jim Harbaugh and Michigan beating Oregon State. Auburn survives. Maryland goes down to Bowling Green. And Notre Dame in a thriller against Virginia.
Has anybody seen the Pac-12 this year, Rich?
Arch, your old conference has been beaten up a bit early. It's early, but last week wasn't good. Obviously, a win in East Lansing by the Oregon Ducks would go a long ways to helping that out.
It's going to be a tough game for the Ducks.
First and 10 for Nevada. On Jackson, right side. it's been the left side where Nevada's had their best success, maybe because Reggie Gilbert is lined up on that side of the ball.
Yeah, they really haven't been able to get much going on that right side. Earlier, you saw Turi involved. That time, Reggie Gilbert. Jeff Worthy got in on some action. You have to get a good drive here. The last thing you can do is give the ball back to Arizona in that offense with time left on the clock.
Stewart steps up and delivers, deflected and almost intercepted. I'm not sure what it hit or if the receiver was screened by the umpire. It's third down and 10.
Well, another opportunity right here, and Tyler Stewart enjoying great protection. And Jericho Richardson just crosses the middle. You see that ball is tipped. And that's maybe why Richardson lost some concentration, but still had a good chance of bringing down that ball.
So it's third down, and third down has not been good for the Wolfpack. They are 3 of 8.
Well, certainly not third and long. And third and long, when you look at Arizona, last week had a really difficult time in that down and distance. So this is where they want to be in these situations, to see if guys like Gilbert and Turi can get to the quarterback.
Arizona brings four. Escapes, hit again, still on his feet, and finally drops. Right at the line of scrimmage, Jeff Worthy and Reggie Gilbert finished him off. And Arizona's going to get the football back with about 2.5 minutes left in this first half.
It's exactly what they were looking for. And Reggie Gilbert, with a speed rush on the right side, just blew past Jacob Henry. Tyler Stewart did not have a chance. And that's exactly what you want to see. You're going to see Gilbert come right across that edge. Look at how low he gets in the leverage. And that's what you want to see. Reggie Gilbert, who's back for his fifth year, winning a one-on-one situation.
Devontae Neal is deep. Boy with a short kick. And it's going to roll down to the 25-yard line of Arizona. Catch the new movie, Black Mass, from Warner Brothers Pictures, based on a true story of one of the most notorious gangsters in U.S. history. Starring Johnny Depp, in theaters everywhere on Friday. This is a white out that they call to Nevada fans to wear all white and in and around Mackey Stadium. A lot of white, and I think a wise choice on a 93-degree night. There's Solomon and the day that he's had already for 120 yards through the air. Arizona has one timeout left. Caleb Jones, big receiver, has the catch and a gain of 9.
Boy, this is such a huge drive for both teams. Arizona, you get a chance maybe to double up if you're able to punch this in before halftime, because you get the ball to start the third quarter. And Nevada cannot allow Arizona to score here.
Nate Phillips to the 35. You're right. I mean, they could finish the first half with the ball and start the second half with the football.
Yeah, that last drive, the last two drives for Nevada absolutely went nowhere. And credit the Arizona defense for making the plays to get off of the field. Now, minute 41 seconds, that's plenty of time for Solomon in this offense to go down the field.
Not sure why they stopped the clock, because this is a long wait. Rich Rodriguez loves hurry up. He would rather just get it and snap it.
At least we set the game clock to 146. Thank you.
Game clock to 146. Clock starts on ready for play. Arizona with an 11-point lead at their own 35. Solomon fires it out to Grant. And he's hit and knocked out of bounds at the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 6.
When you look at this offense, Rich, I think, first of all, the run game has been terrific so far. And the short passing game has been pretty sharp. The one area that I know they wanted to get better on was hitting those deep shots downfield were a problem last week and still have not been able to convert this week.
Solomon incomplete. He was looking for Caleb Jones. He was actually looking for a deep ball rather than a short route. Third down and four.
Miscommunication outside. Solomon, well, he gets the ball out of his hands quickly, doesn't he? And that's exactly what Rich Rodriguez wants to see.
Rich Rodriguez calls the plays for the Wildcats. And let's see what he dials up here on third down. 0-3 on third down is Arizona.
They're trying to get the ball to Grant. This is your short area guy.
Solomon pulls it back. Across the middle, caught for a first down, Nate Phillips. Inside the 45, clock stops. Arizona has just one timeout.
Now, such a good throw by Solomon. He's moving to his left. And he hits Phillips as he's going to his right.
Casey Scourin's field goal range is 50 yards in for Arizona. This one to the 45. Ball is loose. Still loose. Nevada with a flag down says they have it. This would be an enormous play. And the Wolfpack do indeed have it, but certainly this is something that will be reviewed.
Well, Jordan Dobrich, the middle linebacker, is the one that made the first contact. You're going to see number 49 right here. Tackle Wilson in the hole. Is Wilson down before that ball comes out? And from that angle, it looks like Wilson was able to get that left forearm down on the ground.
Okay. Ruling on the field is a fumble recovered by the defense. First down, Nevada.
You heard the announcement. Now, each coach has one challenge they can use throughout a football game. And we'll see if this is
after
a time.
Sideline warning, Nevada. There's no foul. The second would be a 5-yard penalty.
All right, the flag was for a sideline warning. There's no foul. And we'll see if Arizona uses a challenge or if the officials get a call from upstairs on this look.
I think
he's down.
Recovered by the defense is under review.
I don't think there's definitive proof. But I do think that Wilson was down.
Well, that's the key, definitive proof. Unless there's definitive proof, you can't overturn.
Yeah, you don't actually see the ball moving before he hits the ground, but it doesn't look like the ball squirts out until his body makes contact with the ground. And remember, Nick Wilson had a fumble last week that led to a UTSA touchdown, and he's not a guy that fumbles a lot, so here two fumbles in two games. If they do uphold this call, not a good sign for the Arizona offense.
Nevada is a football team in desperate need of a break. They certainly didn't have one in the first 6 minutes of this game when Arizona scored twice after a muffed punt snap and then a nice Arizona drive. It looked like Rich Rodriguez and the Wildcats were going to blow Nevada out.
Yeah, credit the Wolfpack for staying tough. Again, the problem with this is we don't see, does the ball ever move? Now, the ball does not come out until Wilson makes contact with the ground. So the question, is there enough video evidence to overturn this call?
The major flags in this game have all gone against Nevada, and they've been crushers. One wiped out a touchdown. One kept a touchdown drive going for Arizona. Certainly plenty of time, if this goes Arizona's way, for the Wildcats to regroup and get the offense back and moving.
Well, plenty of time for both teams. If Nevada gets the ball right around midfield, certainly enough time for them, but Arizona with one timeout, with this offense, the way they can get big plays.
After review, ruling on the field of a fumble recovered by the defense stands. First down, Nevada.
Not confirmed, but stands, which confirms your read on it, which was not enough to overturn.
I think if your best guess would be, based on what you saw, that Nick Wilson was down. But because there was zero video evidence that the ball was moving or not moving before he hit the ground, is the reason why that call stands.
You know, the word guess is the important one in that statement. Now let's see if Nevada can take advantage. Just inside Arizona territory. Tyler Stewart standing tall, throwing deep. Man, oh, and then dropped. Victor Gonzalez had it for a moment, and the freshman out of Riverside couldn't hold on.
Well, you have to have it. Jarvis McCall Jr. is beat. And Tyler Stewart throws it exactly where he has to throw it. You get a chance for a strike right before halftime on an explosive play, and he cannot control that ball as he's going to the ground.
Second down and 10. Stewart again. On the mark, it's Richardson with the catch. He's got the first down. It'll stop the clock. And remember, Nevada is out of timeouts with 45 seconds left. Brent Zuzo, his career long, 45. His range, about 50. Stewart. Again, Richardson. This time, shy of the first down, which means the clock will continue to run.
Well, we haven't called Hassan Henderson's name.
Oh, there is an injured player for Arizona, and that's going to stop the clock. Derek Turi-Turi. Nevada is trying to get 5 more seconds back on the clock.
Boys. Arizona linebacking crew has been decimated this year.
First, Scooby Wright. Gregory went out today. Now, Turi-Turi.
And don't forget, Cody Ippolito.
The 10-second run.
Cody Ippolito was a guy that injured his ACL in camp that they were counting on and making a major contribution.
Boy, another disjointed start to that play.
Please set the game clock to 28 seconds. Nevada declined the 10-second runoff. The game clock is stopped on the snap.
All right, and that's why the whistle. The game clock had started on ready for play, not from the snap. There was no 10-second runoff. Nevada declined it, obviously. Second and 4. No timeouts. Final seconds, first half. Stewart, short toss. Richardson, a crossing pattern. And he escapes out of bounds. Now Nevada is in field goal range. 22 seconds left.
But you throw one over the middle, and that's going to take off about 15 to 17 seconds. So right now you're very limited. You either have to go to the end zone or something that can get you out of bounds.
First and 10. Stewart, Richardson, a catch. That clock is going to keep moving.
It's going to be tough. Your only chance right now is to spike it.
And you got to get lined up to do it. There's the spike, and it comes with 8 seconds. Is there enough time to take a shot in the end zone?
I don't think so. The average football play takes about 7 seconds. And if you throw one at the end zone right now and it's bobbled, there's a good chance you're going to run out of time before that ball hits the ground. So your only chance whatsoever is if you want to run some sort of a quick out. But I think you have to kick the field goal. Otherwise, you're really rolling the dice.
Well, you're right. If you get the first down, you don't have time to get up there once they start the clock.
The average play takes 7 seconds. And I just think it takes too long for a play to develop down around the end zone.
Third down, 6. Stewart, got to throw it, he does, and it's incomplete. 4 seconds left on the clock. This is within range for Brent Zuzo, the junior place kicker, and he is coming on down.
That was pretty dangerous, Rich. You know, you try and take a shot at the end zone, but again, I know you want to get 6 points, but surely in this situation with Arizona getting the ball after halftime, if you walked away here with time running out without a chance to kick a field goal, I think you'd be kicking yourself.
You see Zuzo, 8 of 9 in his career from this distance. Arizona calls their last timeout. There isn't a timeout left.
Timeout, Arizona. The third and final half. 30 seconds.
So Brent Zuzo, and this will be about 42 yards. From his position, this is what a 40-yarder looks like. Zuzo, very good, had a great year last year. Last week, he hit a 27-yarder. There's the unit. Wes Farnsworth is the snapper, and the punter, new this week, is Alex Boyd. Officially 41 yards. Kick is up, and he hit it. And so Nevada, with a fumble recovery after a long review, cashes it in for 3 points and is within a score after a shaky start against number 22, Arizona.
I think it's been inconsistent from both teams. At times, they've looked great. At other times, they've had significant issues. And I think the team that is able to fix those issues coming out of halftime is going to be the one that has the advantage.
Fans that have made the trip up from Tucson. Rich Rodriguez of Arizona down with Cassie Gallo.
Well, Coach, that Nick Wilson fumble changed momentum. How do you address it at the half?
Well, he's a good football player. He'll correct the things. I couldn't tell. The guys up in the box that thought he was down or the ground caused a fumble. But either way, we've had some self-inflicted wounds, and we got to fix that.
And how do you fix those?
Just play better. Just execute. It's a good, tough football team we're playing on the road, and we just got to execute better in the second half.
And how pleased are you that your defense has forced 4 3-and-outs so far?
It's been good. As we're walking wounded there, especially at the linebacker position. Just guys are fighting and battling, and we're going to have to do that for 30 more minutes.
Thanks, Coach.
30 more minutes for Rich Rodriguez and number 22, Arizona. The Wildcats on the road. Last year, it was a shootout. Arizona won it by a touchdown. After the break, we'll send you to our CBS Sports Network studio in New York for the Verizon Halftime Report. You're watching College Football presented by GEICO on CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports.
On their left side of their offensive line, how they counter that will be key in the second half.
Arizona gets the football. To start this second half, we check in with Cassie Gallo.
Yeah, Rich, just talked to Brian Polian. He said that the message to his team at the half was they're making too many mistakes, and Arizona is taking advantage. They're scoring too many points off of them. He said they also need to sustain more drives. How they do that is protect the quarterback and get more yardage. And as far as that play in the first quarter where they called an illegal formation in Nevada, had to settle for a field goal, well, Coach Polian was fired up, said the official screwed up, and that was a touchdown, Rich.
Yeah, he's still seething over that one. A lot of penalties against Nevada in the first half. Now Solomon and the Wildcats. First possession, second half. From their 25, Solomon rolls. Hit as he throws, and it's out of bounds. Pressure coming. Lenny Jones, the senior end, the captain of the Nevada defense.
Well, he was rolling to his right, but he had Johnny Jackson down the field, who was wide open, but he just took his eyes off of him at the last second. It was an incomplete pass.
Second down and 10. Wilson, first carry of the second half. And this time, Nevada does a little better job of tackling in space. Jordan Dobrich, a late flag at the 28-yard line.
Well, if you remember in that first half, Rich, the linebackers for the Wolfpack had a hard time getting off the blocks. That time, Dobrich got off the block and made a pretty good tackle in space. I think they might get Lenny Jones
after the
on a possible late hit.
Personal foul. Offense, number 61. 15-yard penalty and rebound. Correction, third ball.
Darn.
You're going to see number 61 right there. That's the center, Kamen Bundage.
And importantly, Adam, since it happened after the play, it's third down. Mm. So they don't get the down back.
Huge mistake right there.
Third down and a bunch. Solomon. That is five. Incomplete. Lenny Jones again with the pressure. And a three and out for Arizona to start this second half.
Outstanding job, Rich, by the senior captain, left defensive end, Lenny Jones. It's kind of curious right there. Two rollout passes on that series for the Arizona offense. Both times pressure in Solomon's face, and he's forced to get the pass out of bounds.
Timeout, Nevada. The first of the half.
Wow, Nevada burned all three of their timeouts in that first half. And they already have burned one here without touching the football. 21-13, number 22 Arizona on the road. A rematch of last year in which these two teams played a thriller in Tucson with Arizona a touchdown better at the end.
But really interesting. I'm trying to figure out what was happening right there for Brian Polian to virtually waste a timeout with only 30 seconds being played here in the second half. He had his punt return team out there.
He may not have had either enough players on or too many and wanted to avoid a flag. Riggleman's kick is a low line drive. It checks up and then rolls out of bounds. Still inside Arizona territory. This is great field position for Nevada to start their second half. Join our panel of experts and host Adam Schein. They'll get you ready for the first NFL Sunday of the year. That other pregame show presented by DraftKings returns tomorrow, 9 a.m. Eastern, only on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. First possession, Nevada. Tyler Stewart in just his third collegiate start at the helm of this Wolfpack offense. Don Jackson left side, and that was the best play that Nevada had in the first half.
And they kind of got away from it a little bit, partly because they were in some pretty funky situations down in their own territory. But, boy, when something is working as well as it was in that first half, you have to go back and make sure that make that defense prove that they've made those adjustments.
How well did Tyler Stewart play in the first half?
I thought he did pretty good. There was a couple opportunities where his wide receivers let him down with some key drops that could have dramatically changed the game, but I thought he bounced back and ran the offense well.
Jackson burst inside the 45. It's a gain of six, but he is shy of the first down. Third down and three.
Well, first half, Nevada only 3 of 9 on third downs. And in their scoring drives, they were able to convert on their third down. So this is a key area. And remember, last week, Arizona had a really hard time getting off the field. Again, they've let Nevada a little bit drive the ball a little bit in that first half. Somebody's got to step up and make a play.
Third down, four. Jackson jumps for it. He lands at the 41. He is right on the sticks. And the mark will make the difference. If it's generous, it's a first down. If not, they're just short of it.
I'm not sure that.
And they are shy of it. It is fourth and less than a yard, and Nevada's going to go for it.
It was a good play by the nose guard. Fuima Ono right there to stack everything up. Big call here for Brian Polian.
Long count. Loose ball. Stewart shy of the first down, and Arizona holds. Jake Matthews finished it off. Good penetration by William Parks. Jeff Castile's defense stiffens. And Arizona gets the football back. They have great field position. Arizona's defense bears down, if you will. And the Wildcats get the football back. Big play on fourth down by Arizona's defense.
Yeah, I got to kind of question this play call. This is Will Parks right here. And he comes, he's in a track stance. This is their nickel player in a track stance, and he just plants Don Jackson to the ground. And remember in that second quarter when Nevada was backed up a little bit by their goal line, they called the same play, and they got stuffed for another big loss. Right now in a critical down, I don't know if putting the ball in Tyler Stewart's hands in a ball handling situation is the right play.
Now Arizona back to work. Nick Wilson. Wilson breaks loose inside the 35, and he's down to the 31-yard line. Elijah Mitchell made the stop. 28 more yards for Wilson, who is up over 130 yards for the game.
Sonny Rufus, who led the team in tackles last week with 12 of them against UC Davis. A little bit different going up against a guy like Nick Wilson, who just trucked him.
Wilson inside the 25-yard line. And that's a gain of six. Jordan Dobrich made the stop for Nevada.
Oh, I like how Wilson is running the ball. He's accelerating through contact. He's reading his cuts. If they can get him on track and work the offense around him, this will be a tough offense to stop.
Solomon escapes, flips it, caught! Wow, what a catch! It's Nick Wilson. A new Solomon picked his way through defenders, kept the play alive, and Wilson hauls it in. First and goal, Arizona.
Well, first of all, terrific awareness from Solomon, evading the pressure of Seau. You can see he throws the ball. This is all Nick Wilson. Two defenders, and he goes up, high points the football, and takes it away from both of them.
Jared Baker in the backfield now with Solomon. This is Baker to the five. Baker to the goal line, and he's just short of it. Inside the one, Elijah Mitchell again with a stop. And this fast-paced, fast-break offense doesn't slow down. Baker, right side, again short of the end zone. And all of a sudden, it's third down and goal. Baker still in. Solomon straight ahead. Is he in? Big pile. Touchdown, Arizona.
Running on the field is a touchdown.
Rich Rodriguez designed the spread some 20 years ago at Glenville State. And one of the misnomers that people have, it's a throwing offense, but it's a great running offense.
Especially if you have the horses like Arizona does. Now the question is, does Solomon break the plane with the nose of the football? You can see the football when he's laying on the ground is over. And I think he was laying on top of bodies, and therefore his knee was not down, and that is correctly called a touchdown. I think he's laying on top of his center, and therefore his knee or no part of his body hit the ground.
It sounds like, and it looks like, the replay official above,
ruling on the field, well, the previous play was a touchdown, it's under review.
He's going to look at it, but I don't know if there's enough evidence to overturn that.
There's no way, not from those angles, that that I think there's any evidence to overturn it. I think he was simply laying on top of his center, and that's correctly called a touchdown.
Now, Kamen Bundage was a welcome mat for 6 points. Bundage, the senior. Remember, this is an offensive line that lost three starters from last year's Pac-12 South champions.
And Bundage was a 26-game starter at guard, and they brought him over to center this year to replace the departed Steven Girola, who was a two-year starter himself. So Bundage, learning that center position on the fly, has been pretty solid here in the first two games of the season.
Both coaches lobbying. Marvell July, the referee. This is a Mountain West crew awaiting the verdict. One more look. This is a good angle right on the goal line. Now you can see the ball come across, but was he down before it came across?
Well, you see Rich Rodriguez shaking his head a little bit, so obviously.
After review, the runner was short of the goal line, fourth down.
Well, they've had a tough go here in the short yardage, and two critical reviews going against Rich Rodriguez and his offense here.
Do you stay with the same play, Solomon straight ahead?
I definitely think you go for this ball. You know, again, Nick Wilson, been pretty tough to stop. So I would give it to your workhorse, the guy that's been averaging over 10 yards per carry in this game.
Solomon keeps, end zone caught, touchdown. Jamadre Cobb, the fullback, rarely used, but a starring role on fourth and goal. Good ball fake.
Pass interference. Defense number 5. Penalty declined. Results of the play is a touchdown.
Good ball fake by Solomon. And Cobb got loose.
I got to tell you, I didn't see that one coming. But evidently, the Nevada defense thinking run up the middle. And they lose the fullback in the flat for an easy touchdown.
After the play, unsportsmanlike, head coach of Nevada. Penalty being forced on the kickoff.
Well, that one has been brewing since the very start of this football game.
Mm-hmm.
He was upset, as Cassie Gallo reported, and we saw it, obviously, with that touchdown that was called back on the illegal formation.
I'd be upset too. Penalties and mistakes have killed your team so far in this game.
Remember, this started when Nevada had fourth and short inside of Arizona territory. Tyler Stewart and Don Jackson couldn't connect. And Arizona takes it down the field. Solomon to Cobb. 27-13.
To tie Tennessee at 17, they're headed to overtime, guys.
All right, thank you, Brent. A thriller there for number 19, Oklahoma. And a reminder, we've got number 13, UCLA at UNLV after this one. Number 22, Arizona here in Reno against the Nevada Wolfpack. Rich Waltz, Adam Archuleta, Cassie Gallo, Anu Solomon. Calm, cool, headset on. 19 of 25. He's following up a really nice start from last week.
Been really sharp underneath. And again, the next step in his development, this offense's progression, is to be able to connect downfield. They haven't been able to do that yet.
Let's go down to Cassie Gallo. Cassie?
Well, Rich, we saw Arizona middle linebacker Hayden Gregory go down in the first quarter. He's still on the sideline, not carrying a helmet. He has a brace on his right knee, and I got the official word he is done for the rest of the game. And even though he's out, he's still been very much a part of this team. He's been chatting it up with his teammates, keeping him motivated, Rich.
Thank you, Cassie. No Scooby Wright, and his replacement, Hayden Gregory, is down now.
And I was talking to Jeff Castile before the game, and just kind of talking about his linebackers, and I said, well, what happens? Who's next? What happens if Hayden Gregory goes down? He said, well, hopefully that doesn't happen, but we're going to have to scramble a bit.
Nevada has to scramble here. They're down 14. Butler, left side. And maybe two. Don Jackson and James Butler rotate in the running back spot for Brian Polian and the Wolfpack.
Boy, Derek Turry up inside.
Where would they be without him today?
I mean, look, you can see him. He's built right. He was a rock inside. Don Jackson ran into a brick wall right there.
Not many linebackers bigger than 6'1", 265. Butler in the backfield, second and eight. Stewart's deep throw, and it's incomplete. Jericho Richardson, who caught seven balls in the first half, was the target. Boy, remember that drop at the end of the first half. Victor Gonzalez inside the five on that long, accurate throw by Stewart.
And a huge drop, huge missed opportunity, and that was just a miscommunication. Richardson was running to the middle of the field, and Stewart obviously throwing the corner. The passing game, the intermediate passing game, the deep passing game hasn't really been in sync tonight here for Nevada.
Third down, eight. Arizona brings four. Stewart's throw on the sticks. Very nice coverage there. Jarvis McCall, who's down on the depth charts, but has played a lot tonight, steps up and makes a big play.
Yeah, he sure has. And that's one thing that you want to see out of this secondary. This is a secondary that doesn't have a lot of experience. Sammy Morrison is a freshman who was playing on one side. Devontae Neal, transferring from wide receiver and only his second start of the season. And so they need to be able to make those plays, those pass breakups, those interceptions. That was an excellent break by McCall Jr.
Nate Phillips is deep. And Alex Boyd's kick touched by Arizona, but it goes out of bounds and a break for the Wildcats. Goodness. Number 22, Arizona, two touchdown lead. In Reno, gets the ball when we return. The Great Reno Balloon Race. 125,000 spectators every year. About 30,000 have filled Mackey Stadium on the campus of the University of Nevada. Number 22, Arizona, two touchdown lead, and the football at their own 32-yard line. Nick Wilson again, and Wilson breaks loose. He's midfield, inside the 30. 29. And he is brought down at the 29-yard line. A huge game for Nick Wilson.
Boy, gaping hole right there. Both linebackers for Nevada up in the line of scrimmage, but he got a terrific block from his right guard, Jacob Alcidek.
Wilson again, and he loses two. Second down and 12. Nick Wilson ran wild, 101 yards in that first half. He has 180 in the game now on just 16 carries. Solomon sacked at the 38. Ian Sayal, the nephew of the Hall of Famer.
Well, it's a speed rush off the edge. Ian Sayow was going to come off of Solomon's left side and was easily able to beat the left tackle over there. I believe it was Freddie Tagaloa.
Third down, 19 in space. Nate Phillips to catch, and that's going to put the football back into field goal range for Casey Scowry. Rich Rodriguez not happy. Scowron's long last year was 49. And this is going to be a 45-yard attempt. Looks like Arizona doesn't have the right personnel on. And they have time on the play clock. Scowron, a former walk-on, former manager of the women's soccer team. And he pushed it wide right. And that's a big miss, especially for the Nevada Wolfpack, who are kind of on their heels right now.
Yeah, they were reeling a little bit, and I looked at this drive for Arizona to see, is this the drive offensively now that you can kind of take over this ball game. And I thought they were just on the verge of that, especially after Wilson with that huge run on first down to get that big play. But defensively, Nevada stepping up, and especially Ian Sayow with a big sack on Solomon to kind of put this offense back a little bit.
Rich Rodriguez obviously not happy. Now, can Nevada move the football? Arizona's defense has made some nice adjustments. Jackson tries the right side, skips across the 35. Gain of 7. Second down and 3.
Well, following the two tight end set, in the first half it was to the left side, this time on the right side. Boy, Evan Fonts, Jared Gibson, getting some very good push out there, creating a very soft corner for Jackson to hit.
On 2nd and 3. Jackson again straight ahead, short of the first down. This will bring up 3rd down and a long one. William Parks made the stop. Parks, a playmaker in the backfield. No Scooby Wright. Out till early October with that meniscus injury. You only lose about, what, 4 major awards when Wright goes out of the game. He won the Lombardi, the Nagurski, the Bednarik, and the Pat Tillman Award, which is for the Defensive Player of the Year in the Pac-12.
It really kind of limits what Jeff Castillo can do on defense, because to lose that kind of production, it's very difficult to try and manufacture it from other places.
Stewart, little flip and a little too strong. Jared Gibson, and once again on 3rd and short, Nevada does not execute, and they have to give the ball back.
You got to have that one. Tyler Stewart, I mean, he has Jared Gibson open in the flat. Play action pass, they get what they want. It looked like Tellus Jones loses Gibson, but he's wide open. You bring that ball down a little bit, and that's going to be an easy first down. So there's been some missed opportunities tonight, both on the receivers for Nevada and also Stewart missing those chances.
Alex Boy will kick. Nate Phillips with a fair catch. Anu Solomon, one of the bright young quarterbacks in this country, the sophomore from Arizona, having a great night in Reno. Number 22, Arizona, on the road, on top, 27-13. AP Top 10, brought to you by the Chrysler 200. Not a lot of great matchups, but right in the middle, you see Michigan State, a 14-7 early lead against number 7, Oregon.
Yeah, that's to be expected. That's to be expected. That's to be expected. Same with that. I mean, Michigan State, Oregon, probably the best matchup of the day right there. Georgia, Vanderbilt, 31-14. But I can't wait until we start getting into some conference play to see some great college football this season.
Speaking of great, Nick Wilson has been all of that in this ballgame. But Celessa Faremo, the junior out of Sacramento, with penetration and a stop.
Well, a lot's been made of this defensive line, and Celessa Faremo right there, number 97, is the blue-collar worker of this defensive line, and did a great job of just stuffing the guard there and making the play.
Solomon, middle, in stride, caught there, Caleb Jones. Nice move, Jones to the 40, and he's hauled down from behind. He is a big receiver, 6'3", 215, and that's a 41-yard hookup from Anu Solomon to Caleb Jones.
Yeah, play action pass, and they got the free safety, Asani Rufus, who terribly bit up, and that's why there was no safety presence in the middle of the field to help on Jones.
Solomon, quick toss to the sideline. Nate Phillips rolled out of bounds. And that's a gain of 6.
Yeah, here's Rufus right here in the middle of the field. He's going to go all the way up and react to the running play, and that opens up the middle of the field, and that's pitch and catch. Nice accuracy by Solomon.
2nd down 4. Wilson, all of a sudden, Nevada a little better against the run. Kevin McReynolds, who had that big goal line play in the first half, made the stop.
Yeah, it's all about getting off of blocks, and you've seen both teams. When you're able to get off blocks, you're able to stop the running game. And it's when they've had the inability to get off those blocks when both teams have gotten gashed.
Total yardage, 147 already in this third quarter for Arizona. Incomplete. Rykeem Yates had his hand up and deflects it.
Yeah, good job inside by Yates. You're going to see him right there, number 55, engaged.
Four down territory for Arizona.
And they've been terrible so far tonight on third and fourth down and short.
Got to get to the 30.
Watch for crossing routes.
Solomon, sideline, incomplete. Contact and a flag at the 8-yard line. Nate Phillips, the intended receiver, Brian Lane, the linebacker, was in coverage.
Pass interference. Defense number 25. Yeah. 15 yards from the first speed spot. Automatic first down.
Well, that's a good call. But Brian Lane in great shape. Great shape. The ball underthrown a little bit. You're going to see contact before the ball arrives at any time, Rich. The ball is slightly underthrown, and the defender does not turn his head. It's going to be an automatic pass interference, no questions asked.
That's an enormous penalty.
Huge penalty.
Brings the ball inside the 20-yard line. Wilson inside the 15 with a gain of 5. Malik Reed, the stop for Nevada.
Yeah, so much of playing DB is just confidence and knowing that you're in position. And once you're in that position, you got to turn into a wide receiver and play the ball.
Solomon, that's incomplete. He was looking for Samaje Grant. Elijah Mitchell had him covered. Verizon red zone numbers tonight, 5 trips, 4 touchdowns. That's pretty good. Third down, 6. Blitz coming. Solomon's throw caught for the first down. And on the sidelines, Caleb Jones squirms to the 6. Two big catches by Jones on this drive. And it's first and goal from the Nevada 6-yard line.
Boy, third and short, fourth and short, medium. You've got to challenge these wide receivers. You can't be off that much and not expect to make a play.
3 wide receivers, top of your screen. Wilson, spinning, touchdown, Arizona. Nick Wilson again. And this time, there is no defensive stop. ...186 yards on 20 carries for Arizona's sophomore running back, Nick Wilson.
Kendall Johnson, the sophomore right here, is the free guy. Played cornerback last year, his first year playing free safety. And then Wilson easily just spins inside and breaks that tackle. But look, when you're playing defense and you have an extra guy, that's where those one-on-one plays have to be made. And Nick Wilson's a good running back. He can exploit you if you give him the chance.
You know, amazing to watch what Arizona did last year, winning the Pac-12 South. They lost to Oregon and went on to the Fiesta Bowl. And they did it with Wilson, a freshman, and Anu Solomon, a freshman.
They played well in their bright moments, right? When they had to play well last year, they did play well outside of that championship game against Oregon, and everything kind of just fell into place.
What have you seen from Nick Wilson that you've liked tonight, among many things?
Well, his breakaway ability. He started the game. I knew they had to get him going early. He showed those abilities to make the tough runs. I think most importantly, and this is how you judge a running back, is once they break the line of scrimmage, can they make that one guy miss? And can you break that tackle? And he's been able to do that. You saw the great catch over there going over two defenders in the passing game. But he's a tough running back to tackle one-on-one, and he showed that here tonight.
Nevada's offense is not necessarily a big play offense. And remember, their quarterback, Tyler Stewart, is in just his third college start. He's not the magician that Cody Fajardo was, or before Fajardo, Colin Kaepernick was. Hassan Henderson made the catch.
Yeah, but he's got to get helped out a little bit by his teammates. You know, he hasn't had terrific protection when they've tried to throw the ball down the field. I think Arizona's defensive line stepped it up from where they were last week against UTSA. And he's had some key drops from his wide receiver. You saw the missed third down pass on their last drive to Jared Gibson. So all in all, I think they're going to turn and look at this game as some missed opportunities.
James Butler, shy of the first down. This has been a down and distance that has befuddled and frustrated Nevada.
Can I give you some advice?
Okay.
Don't call a zone read to the right side. Whatever you do, don't do that. And I think you're going to have a chance. But if you call zone read.
Butler in the backfield. Third down and two. Butler's got the first down. He's across the 40 to the 41-yard line. That moves the chains. Still a lot of football left here.
You know, one place we really haven't seen Nevada attack is the tight end in between the hash marks. And that's the place where Arizona had some difficulty last week against UTSA. So with the running game having some pretty decent success tonight, I would try and get a tight end or a wide receiver behind those linebackers off a play-action pass.
That one almost picked. And Hassan Henderson needed all 6'5" of his frame to haul it in.
Yeah, that was dangerous. Cam Denson was reading Stewart's mail right there. Had a terrific break, almost came down with the interception. What I like what I'm seeing from this secondary that I didn't see from a week ago is that they're doing a better job challenging these wide receivers. I thought last week they played a little bit soft, but the coverage has been tighter against better receivers.
This is Don Jackson. And Jackson's gonna lose a yard. He'll bring up third down and 6.
Now Will Parks again, making a pretty good play. He just ragdolled the tight end, Evan Fonts. And I like the adjustments right now for Arizona. They've come out and played much better run defense here in the second half.
Well, they would rather have that man on the field for this third down. He's over 1,000 in his career, but he's on the sideline for third down and 6.
I expected him to have a much bigger impact in this game, but we just haven't been able to call his number.
4 of 14 are the Wolfpack on third down. Stewart. And a hesitation throw that's incomplete. Butler, the intended receiver. Great coverage downfield by Arizona.
The man-to-man coverage. There was nowhere to throw the ball. And you saw Stewart, he had to pump that ball 2 or 3 times. Finally, the pressure was in his face. But again, the Arizona Wildcat defense challenging these wide receivers and being tight in coverage.
That's Jeff Castile, the defensive coordinator for Arizona. Alex Boyd. Nate Phillips, a fair catch. Time now for Up for Whatever. It's brought to you by Bud Light. This was the catch Nick Wilson made. He had to go up and get it. And that kept the drive alive. Arizona would put it in the end zone. Right now, Anu Solomon, Nick Wilson, and the Wildcats, a 34-13 lead. And the total yardage continues to rise for the Wildcats. Bad snap. Solomon picks it up. In the end zone, flips it, it's incomplete. I believe it's It's incomplete. Needless, incomplete. Seau was there. Solomon had enough time to just flip it forward.
Boy, you're right. At first, I was wondering if he was able to maintain possession. Another lapse on the snap. But you see, the fact that he tucked that ball gave him possession and therefore the incomplete pass. I mean, that's a great job of salvaging disaster by Solomon.
He's fortunate it wasn't picked off for a touchdown. As it is, it's an incompletion. And it brings the football back out to the 15-yard line.
And he tucked that ball as a runner. Good heads-up play, but again, Masani Rufus had a chance for an interception right there.
Has Nevada called another timeout? Yeah, they have.
Timeout, Nevada. The second of the half.
Quick timeout here. Let's go to Brent Stover with an update. Brent.
Rich, two fourth-quarter touchdowns for Oklahoma to send this to overtime against Tennessee. And then Sterling Shepard from Baker Mayfield in the second overtime to give him a seven-point lead. Josh Dobbs picked off by Zach Sanchez to seal it. OU steals one on the road. Back out to Rich, Adam, and Cassie.
Wow, in overtime, sixth consecutive non-conference road win. An overtime thriller. We had an overtime thriller. Minnesota coming from behind, forcing overtime, winning in overtime in Fort Collins against Colorado State. And, of course, coming up, number 13, UCLA at UNLV. I'm not sure why the timeout was called, maybe for a discussion with the officials. As it is, it's second down and 10. And Solomon, rifles one, sideline, coming back. And making the catch is Caleb Jones. How big has he been in the second half? And Solomon is down.
Right, he took a shot by Ian Seau just as he threw the ball. You're going to watch Ian Seau on the inside right there. And he was being pushed by the tackle, Freddie Tagaloa. And it just looked like Solomon landed awkwardly, but I love how Jones uses his body to come back for the football and haul in that pass.
Another look, and you're right. Seau had a man on his back. And let's hope that Anu Solomon is okay.
They could have easily called a hold right there from Freddie Tagaloa, the left tackle. But that's a lot of weight that landed on Solomon.
Play clock to 40 seconds.
You hope that he just got the wind knocked out of him.
And Seau has come off the field. And so Solomon is down. And that is a great sign. I mean, that is a great sign. All of Tucson can exhale now. I mean, we've seen a lot of injuries around the country. And you don't have to say that around Tucson with Scooby Wright out for 3 weeks. Gerard Randall, the senior, will take over. And so Randall inside Nevada territory at the 46-yard line.
Now he's more of the athlete, so you can expect a good chance you're going to get a heavy diet of quarterback run game here.
This would be quarterback run game. To the 43-yard line, Lenny Jones made the stop. And it was short-lived. Gerard Randall goes back out, but great to see Anu Solomon back in.
Absolutely.
Jared Baker, the tailback. Solomon, pump fake, caught and dropped. Sack back at the 48, Lenny Jones again.
Well, you saw Seau from the other side with a hit on Solomon Anu, or Anu Solomon, and then Lenny Jones. Well, that was easy coming off of the other side. This offensive line a little leaky right here in the third quarter.
Fourth quarter coming up. Number 22, Arizona, 34-13. In Reno, Anu Solomon and Arizona, a 34-13 lead, and they have outscored Nevada 13-0 here in the third. Arizona with the football on third down and 12. Solomon Gibbs, Nick Wilson. And Wilson is down to the 40. He is shy of the first down. Rich Waltz along with Adam Archuleta. Impressive stuff from number 22, Arizona. They got off the great start, a little bit of a lull, and then they put their foot back on the gas.
Yeah, they came out at halftime a completely different team from where they were in the first half. It really is the Nick Wilson show on offense. And I think defensively, love the way they made adjustments. Nevada having some success there in that second quarter, running the football, but that defense really started to show how stout it can be in stopping that offense.
Fourth down and four. Going to be a quick kick. Solomon's kick is going to wobble and end up out of bounds. Good field position. All right. If you're Nevada, you've had opportunities. All night you've had opportunities. You got 15 minutes left.
You do, but to win a game like this against a team like Arizona, you have to maximize on all of your opportunities. And right now, I know they had success earlier in the game in the run game, but their passing game has really struggled. They've really missed on some opportunities, both from the wide receivers dropping some passes, and I think there's been some passes that Tyler Stewart would want to want back.
Well, he's going to get his chance. He's got 15 minutes left. Brian Polian. Last year, remember, Nevada was down and came roaring back, and it was a tight finish. Arizona won that game by a touchdown in Tucson. So here is Stewart down the field, and it's picked off. Jamar Allah steps in, the senior out of Phoenix, who had a fumble recovery for a touchdown last week with an interception. Arizona at their 45-yard line. One play and a turnover, and Arizona continues to roll. Number 22, Arizona on top. It has not been a great start of the season for the Pac-12 Conference. Arizona here trying to win in what is not an easy place to play in the Mountain West, in Reno. Nick Rolovich, the offensive coordinator for Nevada, off the turnover. This is Jared Baker. And he has spilled right at the 44-yard line. No gain on the play.
When you look at this defense, I think the most positive aspect of this defense has been the defensive line. You've seen numerous different players make plays on that defensive line. You just saw Malik Reed do just that.
Randall breaks loose. Gerard Randall, length of the field, 57 yards, and a touchdown. And Arizona breaks it wide open. Gerard Randall, the backup quarterback.
Boy, how fast did Randall look right there? Right there, he knows he's scoring. Right now, he's just trying to show off. He's just trying to show everybody how fast he is. And he didn't slow up until he hit the goal line.
Well, you saw what Arizona does with turnovers. Points off turnovers, there's seven of them. Randall pulls it and keeps it and takes it 57 yards.
Six, and on the next play, LJ Scott gets a touchdown, and the Spartans at home lead Oregon 21-14 into the third, guys.
Thank you, Brent. Michigan State, very good at home. Oregon is fearless in going on the road. They'll go east, they'll go to the south, they'll go to the Big Ten.
You got to win on the road.
And the Ducks have done that.
Yeah.
You know, Arizona did that last year on their way to the Pac-12 South. In fact, they won at Oregon. It was obviously an enormous win in getting them to that Pac-12 championship game. Elijah Mitchell will bring it out. Elijah Mitchell down the sidelines, knocked down. And we check in with Cassie Gallo. Cassie?
Well, guys, we are here with a new basketball coach, Eric Musselman, and you can tell he is very excited to be a part of this university. So, Coach, what's the welcome been like so far?
The Reno community has embraced myself and our family and all our new recruits, so we're really excited about the upcoming season.
And you're taking over a program that went 9-22 last year. What's the first order of business?
Well, we're trying to change the culture both academically in the classroom as well as on the floor. And we had to recruit the current players, get them on board with the new program, and then we had to get a strong recruiting class in a very short time, which we feel like we did do that.
And how will your NBA experience benefit you here?
Well, as all high school guys, they all want to either play in the NFL. If they're college football players and college basketball players, their goal is to get to the next level, the NBA. And so we feel like playing in an NBA system is a platform for them to reach their ultimate goal.
And you are fired up all the time. Where does this energy come from?
Energy, enthusiasm, effort. That's what we talk to our players about every day. And obviously, our coaching staff has to bring that to the table as well.
All right, Coach. Good luck this season.
Thanks so much, Cassie.
Rich.
Eric Musselman in a much better mood than Nevada football coach Brian Polian, who just picked up his second 15-yard penalty of the night.
He has been active tonight in talking to the officiating crew. Certainly doesn't feel like a lot of calls have gone his way.
You see the penalty yardage. 9 for 105. And that wipes out a nice return. And since it was after the return, instead of 1st and 10, it is 1st down and 25. And Tyler Stewart, who had a start against Hawaii back in 2013 and then watched the Cody Fajardo show, a start last week. He was very good against UC Davis, but obviously number 22 Arizona, a much different animal. Son Henderson makes the catch, and Henderson is up to the 22-yard line. Cam Denson for Arizona made the stop.
Well, Stewart's so much a different quarterback than Cody Fajardo was. You know, Fajardo was kind of that sandlot, wing it style, improvise, try and take over the game on his own. He was terrific in the quarterback run game. Stewart is more of the passer who does have that kind of elusiveness, but tonight the passing game just hasn't been in sync. I think the timing has been off. I think both Stewart and his wide receivers have missed some key opportunities to move the football, and that's a part of this offense that I think needs work going forward.
And protection hasn't been great.
Well, you would think this Arizona defense, who has kind of struggled in their last three games getting to the quarterback without Scooby Wright, you would have been able to protect Stewart, but I thought this is a much improved effort from the Arizona front seven in beating those one-on-one blocks and getting to the quarterback.
3rd down, 2. Stewart on the money on that throw. Wyatt Demps, the sophomore, with a catch. 1st down. Chains move. Clock stops. Nevada has a long way to go.
This is just valuable practice time, rep time, for this offense going up against what probably will be the best defense they face this entire season.
Hassan Henderson with the catch. And Henderson across midfield to the 47-yard line.
The Wildcat secondary has done a terrific job in controlling Hassan Henderson. I thought coming into this game, that would have been a big mismatch for the Nevada offense against that defense, but he's been quiet and really hasn't had the impact that I thought he would.
Jackson breaks it outside. Good play by Carter Hare, the sophomore. Second down, 4. Stewart will pull it back. to the 25. Stewart. And there's the elusiveness and the athleticism that you talked about. That's a 32-yard pickup for the Nevada quarterback.
That's a great job. Now, you can see that he doesn't have the dynamic ability of a Fajardo or a Colin Kaepernick, but if they can use this strategically and not fumble the snap or not get a tackle for a loss, this could be a nice little piece to their offense, but I think they just have to continue to work at it and use that in very key strategic situations.
Play clock, and they're going to have to burn another timeout here. They've taken way too much time. Nevada uses another timeout, their last. Close to 30,000 here, and they have watched number 22, Arizona, play very well on the road. Nevada with the football, down 41-13, just under 11 minutes left in the football game. Tyler Stewart setting, going to the end zone, and it is incomplete. It'll be second down and goal.
Yeah, it just doesn't seem, Rich, like, you know, from a passing concept, these receivers have been able to establish any rhythm, any timing, any separation here for Stewart to get the ball. And I would have thought maybe play-action game would have been a bigger part of their game, but they really haven't tried to attack the middle of the field, the place where I thought coming in here, the Wildcats were vulnerable.
Stewart to the two. Third down and goal. Ike Tyler made the stop. Boy, Arizona has gone through some linebackers, haven't they? They lost Scooby Wright last week with a meniscus. Hayden Gregory, his replacement, left the ball game in the first half and has not returned.
That's going to be an interesting spot to watch this season. Because in Jeff Castile's defense, they need fast, athletic linebackers. And without having that, that really limits what he's able to do.
And Stewart finds Henderson on a slant. Nevada has a touchdown. Big target is Henderson. And he will be a popular guy around the goal line.
For good reason. But again, coming into this game, arguably outside of Don Jackson, your biggest weapon, a guy that had a good mismatch from a size perspective on this secondary. I'm a little surprised that there wasn't more of an effort to get him involved earlier in the game.
Extra point is good. Early in the fourth quarter, Nevada with a touchdown. Number 22, Arizona, still on top. 41-20. Number 22, Arizona, a 41-20 lead. For those of you waiting for UCLA, the number 13 team in the country, they are in Las Vegas. And the Rebels and the Bruins will kick off at 10:40 Eastern. Carter Blackburn standing by. Aaron Taylor, Jenny Dell as well. We'll get you there as soon as we can. 10 minutes left in this one. This has been a game marred with lengthy reviews, a lot of penalties. And that one's going to come out to the 25-yard line. And now Arizona will try to run some clock with a 21-point lead, a 3-touchdown lead. And if you're Arizona, you got to feel pretty good about yourself. You know, the one thing that is surprising about Arizona, they won the Pac-12 South last year. And so where did everyone pick them to finish this year with a lot of people coming back? Fourth. That, I mean, I don't know if that's a slap in the face, but they won it last year. They've got a lot of people back, and they're picked fourth.
Are you trying to say they're the Rodney Dangerfield of the Pac-12 South?
Randall, who had a 57-yard run for a touchdown last time he touched it, flagged down behind the play. That'll stop the clock. Randall's pickup, 6 yards.
Bodie, offense number 58, 10-yard penalty. Replay first down.
There's your preseason poll in the South. Maybe it speaks to the talent in the South. USC, Arizona State, UCLA, and you see Arizona with Utah and Colorado.
Well, I think Colorado, we know they have their problems. But you look at any other of those five football teams, and any one of those teams can win on any given Saturday. So I don't think anybody really knows how the Pac-12 South is going to shake out.
Arizona keeps it on the ground. Orlando Bradford, his first kick. Bradford is across the 40, number 3 on the depth chart. And he gets his first shot. He picks up 33 yards.
Oh, boy, you have to wrap up. When a guy like that breaks into the secondary, Teray Callaway, number 30, comes in here right there and tries to throw his shoulder into him. But look, at this level, you've got to wrap up. Put your arms around him. A guy like that is just going to run right through it. That was a terrific hard-nosed run out there by Bradford.
So Arizona, they're on 47. Again, Bradford, this time into Nevada territory, the 47-yard line. Arizona, you look at their schedule, they've got Northern Arizona next week. They open Pac-12 play on the 26th of September at home against UCLA. Then Rich Rodriguez and the Wildcats go on the road. They hope they'll have Scooby Wright back for that October 3rd game at Stanford. Of course, they're hopeful to have Hayden Gregory back as soon as possible as well. Zach Green with the carry. Here's that schedule for Arizona.
Well, look, they've had a pretty good start to their season. UTSA last week here in Nevada. They won this game, Northern Arizona. They're going to have a big test against UCLA, and that's the one where we're going to find out exactly what kind of team Arizona is. But look, Stanford looked mediocre against Northwestern, Oregon State. They had their problems this week against Michigan, Colorado. They have their issues as well as Washington State. So, I mean, that's a pretty good middle part of this schedule that if Arizona gets this thing lined up right, they could get on a pretty good roll.
If they can get through UCLA and Stanford. And it's Green again on the carry. Well, the Wildcats, and remember, Rich Rodriguez in his fourth year, they lost to Oregon in that Pac-12 championship game last year. Ended up in the Fiesta Bowl, where they lost to Boise State, 38-30. That a, what do they call it now, a New Year's Six bowl game. So a Power Five team, Arizona, from a Power Five conference. Sideline throw caught there against Nevada here, which is a Group of Five team from a Group of Five conference. And everybody wants to play in a New Year's Six. There's a lot of numbers out there, Arch.
That's a pretty good payday.
I know, but
in that bowl, everybody wants to play in the Fiesta Bowl.
It's new jargon.
Yeah.
New jargon in this new age of the college football playoff. Third down short.
They probably get pretty good gift bags in that bowl.
Yes, I would expect they do. Shotgun snap, keep it on the ground. This is Bradford, and Bradford to the 30. And this is a nice drive here for the Wildcats. Obviously, Nevada trying to strip the ball. You've got the third string tailback, Orlando Bradford. Gerard Randall, who had a really nice run, running the show after a quality start from Anu Solomon.
Yep. And Randall, it's nice to when you have to close a game out with a backup quarterback like Randall, who has that running ability, and the defense has to account for that quarterback, and you know you're not putting your starter in harm's way to have a weapon like that.
Randall waiting for the play clock to run down before every snap. Corey Rush with the stop. Tonight's AdvoCare champion of the game. Oh, this one pretty easy. 194 yards on just 21 carries. Nick Wilson, his eighth career 100-yard game.
Now, I thought it was very smart of this offensive staff to get him involved early. It took him kind of a while in this offense, a while to get going last week. As you see those numbers right there, 83 of those 97 yards in the second half. But you can see how good he is, not only breaking that first tackle, but when he gets in the open field, he has tremendous speed.
Bradford, Arizona is now over 300 yards rushing in the ball game.
It's a pretty good number.
Yeah,
a pretty good number. I think, you know, Rich Rodriguez, I think he'll take that. You know, they love to throw it around, but this offense and their scheme is all about getting the matchups and forcing defenses to try and account for their multiple players. And if Solomon can get good at his post-snap read, and if he can make that right read and get it to the right person, I think this is going to be a very dangerous offense to try and defend this season.
Randall knocked out of bounds, and that draws the ire of Rodriguez. You can see him scolding his senior quarterback. He wanted the clock to continue to run.
Defensive injury to injury timeout.
Corey Rush. Is down for Nevada. Well, if you're Nevada, it doesn't get much easier next week. I mean, Nevada here against number 22. Next stop, College Station, to take on Texas A&M.
Yeah, it's not an easy start, but it's valuable experience for a team that's trying to figure out how to win.
And that's the injury to Corey Rush, redshirt freshman out of Salt Lake City. UCLA, number 13 in the country, in Las Vegas against UNLV. Josh Rosen, the UCLA quarterback, had a great start to his season. His first college start, and of course UNLV rebuilding. Tony Sanchez, the head coach. He was the head coach of Anu Solomon at Bishop Gorman High School in Las Vegas, and you saw them last week. Progress?
Big time progress. You know, they still have a lot of issues there, and it's going to take, I think, a while to turn that thing around there in Las Vegas, but it was a much sharper team. It was a much more disciplined football team. And I think if there's one guy that can kind of turn things around over there, Tony Sanchez seems to have the passion and the energy for Las Vegas to get that accomplished.
Fourth down and four. Gerard Randall waiting for the play clock to run down. Arizona trying to pick up this fourth down. Flags down. And a procedure call.
False start. Offense number 65. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
So this is going to become.
Correction. Fourth down.
Fourth down.
God.
And about nine. And Arizona. Let's see if they bring on the field goal kicker, Casey Scourin. They will. So Scourin trying to add 3 points after a time-consuming drive. This is going to be a 46-yarder. He missed from 45. His career long is 49. And this one he brings back in. So Scourin with three. Arizona's lead is now 24. Number 22, Arizona, staring at 2-0.
Football on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. By Bud Light, the perfect beer for whatever happens. And by Cooper Tires, life's a road trip. Come on, let's go.
Downtown Reno, we will get you to Las Vegas. And the Silver Bowl, home of UNLV, number 13, UCLA and UNLV, coming up. Carter Blackburn, Aaron Taylor, Jenny Dell standing by. Nevada has this one sail into the end zone, and they'll take a knee and get it at the 25-yard line. Tomorrow, NFL on CBS, home to Super Bowl 50, and it starts with a big-time doubleheader. Check your local listings, and it starts with JB, Tony, Bart, Coach, and Boomer on the NFL Today, presented by Southwest Airlines. And on that little schedule, you go down and find Tennessee at Tampa. Look at this quarterback matchup. Didn't we just see these guys in the Rose Bowl in a semifinal game?
I think it's pretty neat. I mean, we get a chance now after both of them having participated in their preseason games. I think maybe the consensus is that Mariota had a better preseason than Jameis Winston, but now, boy, both a chance to start the season. I'm excited, and I think, Rich, when you look at these the NFL, the storylines, every team has major storylines and question marks.
First time two quarterbacks who were taken with the first two picks have opposed each other in their NFL debut.
We didn't get to see Peyton Manning and Ryan Leaf. No.
You're a funny guy. No. The Chargers did not open with the Colts.
I think I would have known how that one ended up. But this one will be a fun one watching these two players. I think they're both have bright futures in front of them.
You saw Hunter Frelick. He's in there. So is Blake Wright. A pair of freshmen. Both redshirt freshmen. And so Nevada's going to have to regroup and go to College Station to take on Texas A&M.
That's going to be a beast, you know, playing in that environment. But I think, you know, one thing this football team, when you look at Nevada, they haven't shied away from playing the big boys. I mean, they played Florida State a couple years ago. I mean, they go after it and they compete, and I think it's valuable experience. Remember, this is still a very young football team that Brian Polian has on his hands.
Third down and four. Wright stuffed at the 30-yard line. And the clock approaches 2 minutes. We will get you out to Las Vegas shortly. We check in with Cassie Gallo. Cassie.
Yeah, Rich, have an update on Nevada's Corey Rush. The trainers have been working on his right ankle. You could tell he was in a lot of pain, not having a lot of success putting pressure on it. They're bringing a cart out for him, so he's down for the rest of the game, guys.
All right, thank you, Cassie. Nate Phillips deep for this Alex Boyd punt. So we're headed to Las Vegas. We're currently in Reno. Now to New York with Brent Stover. Brent.
Well, Rich, UCLA on their opening drive after UNLV went three and out. The Bruins, Josh Rosen, just fired in another touchdown pass. That's four early on in his career as a freshman. 6-0 UCLA will get there in moments. Rich, Adam, and Cassie.
All right, thank you, Brent. He only threw for 351 yards last week in his debut.
Who did they play?
Come on, Art.
That's just the one thing. Sometimes stats in college football, you can't just go by stats. We got to put it in context. That's why sometimes these Heisman Trophy winners, they pad their stats against competition that they shouldn't be playing against.
Well, this one for Arizona may be against a Mountain West opponent, but this is not an easy environment or an easy team. Ask Rich Rodriguez. In the New Mexico Bowl in 2012, these two teams met, and it went down to the wire. It was a one-point win for Arizona. And then, of course, last year in Tucson, Arizona, a seven-point win. This, a much greater margin here.
And I think there were pieces that the Nevada football team put on tape that had them worried. They had a strong running game. They had some kind of mismatches on the outside, and I think their defensive line going up against an offensive line that's been rebuilt, I think, was a big concern of Rich Rodriguez. But the good thing for him is his football team responded in the second half and really did the things they had to do to win.
He needs to get his linebackers healthy and get ready for that conference opener against UCLA. They've got Northern Arizona next week. Final seconds here in Reno. And certainly the Wolfpack will have to regroup in a hurry. Final knee and the final snap. 11-0 in non-conference games under Rich Rodriguez. Number 22, Arizona, is now 2-0 for Carter Blackburn, who's coming up. Aaron Taylor, Jenny Dell in Las Vegas. Rich Waltz, Adam Archuleta, Cassie Gallo. Let's head to Las Vegas. Number 13, UCLA and UNLV. Take it away.